West Lavington is a small village in Wiltshire of about 1,500 people. It lies on the north edge of Salisbury Plain and is located between the towns of Devizes and Salisbury. The first owner of Fowler 8903, or the Brickyard Fowler as she was known locally, was the family firm of Holloway Brothers, who came from West Lavington. They bought the engine new in 1900. Perhaps somewhat surprisingly, she was delivered on New Year's Eve. This large engine was used at the Holloway Brothers Brick and Tile Works, located nearby in the Broadway Market Lavington. They had acquired the business in 1894 from the William Box family, and the engine worked there for a period of more than 20 years. The Fowler actually replaced Fowl number 18, built in St Ives, Cambridgeshire by Fowl, with a box-designed main drive coupling in 1882. This was an 8-horsepower single-cylinder engine. The Brickyards was a rambling complex on both sides of the road, interspersed by various ponds created by the digging out of clay. It had a wide range of buildings, a carpenter's shop, foundry, weighbridge, drying sheds, a pottery building, stables, and of course, an engine shed. In this photograph is one of the main buildings fronting onto Broadway, and you can just see the Holloway Brothers sign on one of the gables and the name, the Market Lavington Brick, Tile and Pottery Works. You can also see one of the haulage wagons used behind the Brickyard Fowler, and indeed some of her wheel tracks in the earth in the foreground. The works produced bricks and tiles for many decades, even after the Holloway family had sold it, in fact, right up to the outbreak of World War II. The brickworks had about 25 employees at the turn of the century, as we can see from this circa 1900 photograph. A couple of faces are identifiable. In the back row, fifth from the left is Jimmy Coleman, and seventh from the left is George Brown. Both men worked with the Fowler Brickyard engine. Holloway Brothers was set up in 1882 by Henry Thomas Holloway and Henry Holloway, aged 29 and 25 respectively. Henry Thomas, or Thomas as he was called, was originally a bricklayer and then became a general foreman at the very early age of 21. Henry originally worked as a clerk within a timber merchant company. Holloway Brothers was established in London and expanded rapidly in the early 1900s, becoming a leading English construction company and was also active abroad. Initially, they ran a wharf near Westminster Bridge, which was superseded by one adjacent to Vauxhall Bridge. The combined skills of the brothers, Thomas and Henry, were the reason for this success. Thomas was a master of building practice and economics, and Henry a remarkable administrator. Thomas had 6 children, and the youngest, Frank Herbert, who can be seen in this photograph reclining on the floor, later ran the Market Lavington Brickworks. Henry had 8 children, of which 6 were boys. 3 of these all worked in the family firm: Herbert John, Norman James, and Roland Everly. Herbert John as director and Roland Everly as managing director and then later as director spent their whole working lives in the Holloway business until they retired in 1956. A painting called A London Landscape gives an impression of the size of the business in London. It shows their bridge wharf next to Vauxhall Bridge on the north side of the Thames, located around 157 Millbank, Westminster. The painting was produced by Donald Maxwell at the beginning of the 20th century, possibly around 1920, And if you look closely, you can see two steam engines captured in steam working at the wharf. The wharf was used by Holloway Brothers until the 1960s, and today the site is a residential tower next to a garden called River Walk. Luckily, we still have some photographs from other parts of the business. In Battersea, Holloway Brothers had a large stone masonry works, and in Earlsfield, there was a sawmill with various joinery works and timber storage areas. Locally, Holloway Brothers was also busy, one of their early jobs being the provision of bricks for the new Lavington Viaduct between West Lavington and Market Lavington, part of the Sturt and Westbury Railway used by the Great Western Railway. This viaduct was completed in 1902 and is 110 metres long and 12 metres high and still exists today. Thomas Holloway acquired West Lavington Manor in 1905 with 2,500 acres of land and much of the village itself. And Holloway Brothers completely restored it up to 1910, when the family moved in with a staff of 12. It was a Jacobean house with a rather tragic history. In the 17th century, it was almost completely destroyed by fire and had been left to decay over many decades. The banqueting hall was converted into a stable, and the hammer beams covered by unsightly match boarding. In 1907, Thomas took over control of the company. A coat of arms was granted to him in 1909, which read, "Absque labore nihil," a down-to-earth but fitting tribute to the brothers' hard-working but ambitious attitudes. It meant, without toil, nothing. Henry was the president of the Institute of Builders by 1899, and during the First World War was approached by David Lloyd George to help provide much needed countrywide housing for munitions workers. He completed the task within 6 months and was consequently knighted Sir Henry Holloway. Interestingly, Henry set up the Holloway Trust Prize, which still exists today and is awarded by the Architectural Association School of Architecture in London to promote architectural education in the building industry. He was chairman of Holloway Brothers until his death in 1923. Frank Holloway was Thomas's youngest son and was born in 1885. He was in charge of the Market Lavington Brickworks before and after the outbreak of the First World War. After leaving school, he trained as an electrical engineer and became a member of the Institution of Mechanical Engineers. He married when he was 32 and had one daughter, Jean. He was awarded an MBE for his work in North West England with the Ministry of Munitions. But sadly, he died of appendicitis in 1920 at the age of 35, and just 3 months after the birth of his daughter. Both Frank, his daughter Jean, and his father Henry Thomas are buried in a family grave at All Saints Church in West Lavington. One part of the Holloway family still lives and farms in West Lavington today, and welcomed Lord Roberts back to her former home in July 2018, when the engine attended the village fete at the West Lavington Village Hall. A number of Holloway descendants attended this rather special reunion with their Brickyard Fowler.